in a day and time where so many actors and celebrities and athletes are Twittering nonstop, at least one superstar athlete tells me you'll never find him on Twitter. Check it out.
It's almost a shame that when you played, you didn't have the internet exposure like today. You would have been bigger than life.
I don't think I would want that. All this accessibility to these athletes, and look at Michael Phelps. I mean, it's incredible. Just in 2 seconds, his whole life changed.
Right.
You know, I mean, it's you sort of want to stay clear of all that stuff. And I, in the 90s, you know, it was just starting to come around, this exposure and TV and internet. And now it's gotten to the point where, you know, you're on your BlackBerry 24 hours a day.
Twittering. You don't Twitter.
I don't Twitter. I think Twittering is one of the most ridiculous things I've ever heard of. I just don't get it.
As a basketball fan, I gotta ask you this. I've seen you at Staples Center.
Yeah.
Kobe or LeBron?
Well, LeBron, I think, is a more powerful, I don't want to say he's a better athlete, but you know, those things that Kobe can do at the end of the game, I would want him to have the ball. So I would want Kobe at the end and maybe LeBron throughout the game. I mean, the guy's a stud. But Kobe, he's a four-time champion now. It's hard to beat that.
One of the greatest tennis players in the history of the game. What's it like to live every day with that title?
You know, I honestly don't think about it much. You know, I had my time. I did my thing. I was good at it. You know, I don't look at it myself as anything better than anyone else. I happen to play great tennis. I never let it get to my head. I try to stay humble through it all. But I'm proud of what I did and the way I did it. So it was, I don't think about it much, honestly.
How come the United States tennis is not like when you played, both in men and women, were kind of way behind versus the Eastern European players?
Well, it's gotten so universal, this game. I mean, so many great players coming from all these different countries. Look at, you know, Djokovic and Murray. I mean, there's the European guys. And, you know, we have Roddick, who almost had a big splash there at Wimbledon, but the depth isn't there. It's a little thin. And I don't know why. It just goes in cycles. You know, before I came on the tour, I mean, people were saying, wondering, you know, about American tennis. Now it's what had in the 90s. I mean, me, Agassi, Courier, Chang. Now it's a little slim, but, you know, hopefully Query and Roddick do have a good open, and you get some young kids coming up, so we'll see.
But I want to know, what's your take? Are you enjoying when athletes Twitter, or do you just ignore it? Let me know. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.